When you think of the concept of learning, what do you imagine? Courses, instructors, assignments, or exams? These are all substantial aspects of learning, but in truth, learning isn't always so by the numbers. Informal learning is a type of learning that happens every day, whether we realize it or not. Informal learning theory is thought to be how we, as humans, learn around 90% of the time. Now let me introduce you to Max. Max is a high school student. He has always had an interest in technology and science, which is why he decided to become a volunteer firefighter. While working at the fire department, he doesn't only gain a lot of technical knowledge, but also important soft skills, such as how to assume responsibility. His biggest wish is to become an engineer. To study engineering, good grades are essential. Unfortunately, Max is not a top student, which makes his dream seem to be unattainable. Lots of the skills demanded by the labor market in the future won't be based on theoretical background knowledge, but based on hands-on experience, which is often the result of an informal learning process. Max's situation shows that volunteering plays an indispensable and capital role in lifelong learning. Volunteering enables volunteers to develop skills and competencies for personal, social, and civic development that one could not have gained in traditional or professional systems. However, today, these competences are seldom recognized by formal education, companies, or institutions. Volunteering needs and deserves targeted support from all stakeholders: volunteer organizations, governments, businesses, and an enabling policy environment. Competencies acquired through volunteering activities need to be better recognized in society. This is the reason why we have started ImproVal. ImproVal is a 2-year Erasmus Plus project involving 5 partners from 5 European countries. It aims to provide a synthesis of the work undertaken in the EU on the validation of volunteering experience. But why is this so important? More and more people and organizations are becoming aware of the educational value of volunteering. At the same time, no bridges between projects have been created, which includes the risk of reinventing the wheel on the one side and missing links on the other side. In the first stage of the project, we brought together the results of previous European and in some cases domestic projects that have dealt with the validation in the voluntary sector, analyzed them, and produce an online compendium where all these results can be easily accessed. Our most important findings were that the number of the tools per country is often very small. Some countries don't provide tools at all. Some tools are available only in the language of the country. But there are also quite a few multilingual tools that can be used throughout Europe. The total number of tools that we have found is 45. A compendium of all tools and a tool map can be found on our website. At the moment, we are collecting data from volunteers and voluntary organizations that have used validation tools developed in prior projects to discover whether and how they have been able to use the outcomes of validation. After that, we will be writing an article on their basis for publication on the project's website and for a scientific or other journal. The results of our research will be published by the beginning of next year. In the third and last stage of the project, we will provide recommendations for validation in the European voluntary sector, education policy recommendations, and recommendations for future projects and research. And engage stakeholders in a dialogue on validation and volunteering in a European context. Now let's go back to Max again. By using one of the many validation tools, his skills acquired through volunteering will get validated and recognized. he might get a degree or any other kind of validation that helps him on his way to becoming an engineer. The recognition of competencies acquired through his volunteering do not only increase his chances of finding a job, but might even counter the increasing shortage of skilled labor. I think that's what we call a win-win situation. Are you a volunteer or volunteer facilitator? Check out our website www.improval.eu and stay updated with our project.